brain transplant, if it were possible, is the only transplant surgery where you'd rather be the donor than the recipient. You have to think about that one for a minute. So if I get a new heart, I'm still me. If I get a new lungs, or if I get a new prosthetic leg, I'm still me. But if I get a new brain inside this head, and this brain goes off someplace else, what is me? Let's imagine that we could take one neuron out of my brain and we could replace it with a little artificial neuron made of silicon or something. And that artificial neuron mimics the function of the natural neuron in all ways that we can measure. So it has the same 1,000 connections with the same strength. That neuron has the ability to change its synaptic connection weights with the other neurons as a function of learning the way the natural neuron does. And then the question is, if I have, you know, all but 100 billion neurons are natural and the one is artificial, am I still me? And I think the answer obviously is yes. And then you just keep doing that experiment. You keep replacing them one at a time. And, you know, 100 billion neuron replacements later, you have a completely in silico brain. And would that brain be conscious? Would that brain be human? Would that brain be Bill in a real deep, meaningful sense of the word? I think the answer is yes. I don't think there's anything magical about carbon, nitrogen, hydrogen, and oxygen as building blocks. What's magical is the way those elements are hooked together, the way that they're organized, and the information processing capabilities that get endowed by virtue of that high-level organization.